Hi dancers, thank you for joining me with this warm-up, conditioning, stretching set with me. So let's begin. So we're just going to take a few deep breaths. So inhaling, lengthening, stretching, reaching, exhale. Inhaling, exhaling. Just checking the screen. Inhaling, exhaling. And when you inhale and lift, can you lengthen the spine? Think about the vertebrae. Exhale, push down through space. Inhale, exhale, contract around the ribcage, push down. So let's take that inhale and open the chest a little more, look up. And then exhale, chin to the chest, press down. Inhale, open the chest, arms slightly farther back. Looking up, it's almost like a standing cat and cow. And exhale, shoulders are down, round your upper back, chin to the chest. And then one last set, opening. Fingers spread wide, look up, open the chest. Take an inhale. Exhale, tuck the pelvis, round the back, chin to the chest. Break your wrists, make a fist. Maybe press the shoulders down, chin down. And then let's inhale, step back. We're gonna start on the left every time, so if you can try to remember to do that, and if I can try to remember to do that, we'll do that. So take an inhale here, stretching the side body, tucking the pelvis, and then coming to a wide straddle. Exhale. And inhale. And also, if you can keep your breath flowing throughout, that's great. Shoulder down and exhale. And then we're gonna take it to the left, and just up and over, and then just come forward halfway with a flat back, reaching around and cycling up. Breath is flowing, and then come all the way down, weight into your toes, spread your toes wide, side bend up, and then other direction, side bend, and flat back coming forward, just halfway first, and side bending. Just waking up the torso, waking up the hamstrings, and coming all the way down. Weight into the toes if you can, and around. And then we're gonna reach forward with the flat back and fold over that left leg. And tuck the chin. Try to work towards bringing the belly and the body, the torso, draping over that leg. Working towards a straight leg, gently. Working on flexibility in the hamstrings. Shoulders away from the ears, belly pulls in. Lengthen, take an inhale. Exhale, maybe deepen the stretch. And then the bent knees, then we're going to bend the right knee. Take that left arm over the head in a big circle, open up, bring the hand behind the back, either at the low back or reaching around to your thigh. Look over your left shoulder. And then come back to center, then we bend the knees, there we go. And tuck the pelvis, round the back, come up, inhale. Same thing, other side. Try to twist as gently and as much as you can over the right leg. Coming down with a flat back and rounding over it. Bring your weight to your toes, gently working towards, it might take time, a straight right leg. Shoulders away from the ears. Remember, you're a dancer. Inhale, lengthen the upper body. Exhale, drape it down. Come to center. Bend the knees as deeply as feels comfortable. Maybe it's only a little bit, right? That's fine. Let's look forward in this deep bend. Maybe elbows on the inside of the knees. And then lengthen the legs, fold forward. Chin tucks under, shoulders down, weight in your toes. Inhale, forward, flat back. Exhale, forward, fold. Inhale, look forward, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. And then walk your feet together. Let's have the feet hip distance apart and just bend the knees, roll up. And then you can decide whether you want to keep the feet hip distance apart or bring them together. We're going to take an inhale. Interlace the fingers, palms up towards the ceiling. Exhale, shoulders down, chest down. And we're going to try to keep the palms up towards the ceiling. Bring the thumbs to the base of the skull. Exhale again and drop the chest down. Lock it in with your upper abs. Pull the elbows back against it. Shoulders down. Take both fingertips to the outer edges of your shoulder blades. Lift your elbows up. And if that's not happening today, that's fine. Just a gentle stretch and take everything at your own pace. Modifying whenever you need to. All good. This is just warm up, stretch, some conditioning. Let's inhale, arms up. And then exhale, twisting to the left, just circling the wrists, and then inhaling back to center. Shoulders down every time. Exhaling, gentle wrist circles, and inhale, center. And then exhale, arms down. Let's inhale, arms up. Interlace the fingers, and exhale, fold forward just halfway with the flat back. Inhale your arms out to the side. Exhale, interlace the fingers. Inhale your arms out to the side, T-shape. Exhale, interlace the fingers. Weight is in your toes, belly pulls in. One more time, inhale the arms out to the side, then interlace your fingers behind your back. Fold forward. Pull those shoulders away from the body, and if that doesn't feel great, or if you just what prefer to just release, like grounding, take the palms to the floor. Keep your breath flowing. Try to bring the weight in your toes. Again, gently working on straightening the legs. And then gently release your arms, interlace your fingers with a flat back. Let's inhale up. Maybe tucking the pelvis slightly, just a gentle baby back bend. Maybe, maybe not. And exhale. And inhale. Interlace the thumbs, arms long, shoulders down. We're gonna start with the left foot and right foot. Let's take that 10 times. 1, 2. Exhale every time you fold forward, if that feels good. 4, 5, 6. Flex the feet as they come up. 7, 8. Last 2, last 1. Inhale, interlace the fingers, palms up toward the side, sky. Lengthen the side body, lift up and over to the left. Looking up at the ceiling, maybe, if that feels good. Gently moving the elbow out of your vision. Both shoulders down, both sides. Push your hips to the right. Think about lifting up and over on the left. Pull the belly in, protect your lower back. And then inhale. Lengthen, 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 lengthen. More long as you lift up and over to the right. Either looking straight forward or looking up above. Gently opening the chest. Pull that left shoulder down, especially. Straightening that left leg. Pushing the hips to the left. Lifting up and over on the right. Opening the chest, shoulders down. Elbow out of the way, gently. Inhale. Take a little torso rotation, left around to the right around to the left, letting the head follow, and then keeping the head in the center, just a little circle, and a little circle. Bring the arms down, a little circle with the head, maybe just back and forth, circle with the shoulders, in opposite direction. And we're gonna bring the fingertips to the shoulders. We're gonna take a big circle with the elbows, chin down, like a standing cat and cow. And then try to have the elbows touch every part of that circle. Open the chest, look up, inhale. And then exhale, collapse. Elbows try to touch, inhale, open. And let's go the other direction. Inhaling. Exhaling. Inhaling. Exhaling. And one more time, inhaling. Exhaling, and just release the arms. And let's do a big circle starting on the left. Need to remember that. Just 4 circles each side. Big circles. And other side. Pull the belly in. Remembering the other arm that's not in use. And then we're going to take it opposite direction. Two, three, four, and other side. One, two, three. Can you relax your thighs and your face and breathe? And let's just shake that out. And then let's take, vinyasa flow. So you can have your feet again together or hip distance apart. And we're going to inhale, arms up. Exhale, reach forward, dive forward with a flat back. Inhaling up, flat back, weight in your toes. Exhale, plant the hands, step your feet back into that down dog. Pull the belly in. You can either hold the hand in a neutral position or let it hang. Cycling the feet, so pedaling the feet, I should say. Pull the belly in, try to bring those sitting bones up and back. Just take a moment, take a breath. Shoulders down, lengthen the arms, press into the finger pads. And then from here, I want you to step the left foot leg forward. Come into a high lunge. And if that's not comfortable to you, just bring the knee down. And in this high lunge, we're just going to take a side stretch each side, just a few times. Yeah. Hopefully that feels nice. And then we're going to take a little flow. Arms forward, torso forward, arms up. Maybe look up. Everybody's going to tuck the pelvis forward the whole time. Back and up. Let's inhale and exhale. And just one more time. Inhale. Exhale. And then step that back foot in quite a bit. Come up to standing, open the arms into this warrior two position. Back foot is at an angle. You're trying to open the hips to the front in the direction you're facing. And from here, we're just gonna take a little opening and closing of the pelvis, moving of the pelvis. So we're gonna come into our lunge, bring the arm forward and open. So we're pivoting on that back foot, going into the ball of the foot, and then we're just bringing the heel down, right? And if you want, you can bring your hand on your hip and feel how the pelvis is moving on that right side, right? Just a few more. And then I thought, I'm trying to incorporate a few opening of the arms, chest, in terms of what our lives might be like now. Just thought that might be nice. So incorporating that when I can. And last time. And then just bring your hands back, step that foot back. Take a breath here and down dog. And then step the right foot forward. Again, you can have the knee on the floor for this first part if that feels good to you. And then you're gonna come up with your torso. And we're gonna take a little side bend, reaches here, bringing that left hip forward, tucking the pelvis. And then we're gonna take our little flow, coming forward. And up, inhaling. And exhaling, keeping that left hip forward, inhaling, and exhaling, and inhaling, and exhaling. And then let's come up, let's bring that back foot in, back foot at a diagonal, arms out. Hopefully it's okay, staring at my back. And we're gonna do that same flow here. We're gonna come into the lunge, bring the arm in, and then we're gonna open the hip out. And again, you can bring your hand that left hip and feel the pelvis moving back and forth. Breathing through this, planting down through your right foot, spread all the toes on the floor. Keep that thigh engaged and breathe. Feel the opening in the arms, feel the working of the shoulder blade, and breathe. And be really appreciative. I'm appreciative that you guys are here with me. Let's come down to the floor. Step the foot back, and then we're going to lift the left leg up, and then bring the knee to the chest, shoulders away from the ears, and step it forward into a pigeon stretch. I like to do this every morning. And you can adjust your heel so it's in front, in line with your hip bone. You can flex the foot, point the foot, relax the foot. You can bring it farther away or closer. What I really want you to focus on is taking your right hand behind your right hip, push that hip forward. And then from here, we're going to take a little walk over to the left and just hands over to the left, we're grabbing the back thigh. And then gently taking a twist over to the right, grabbing the back leg, or just hands to the side where it feels comfortable. And then I want you to come down and then walk onto your elbows, maybe lengthening the arms out into the full position. Expression of the position, that's the word I'm looking for. Maybe rock side to side, gently with the hips, and then walk yourself gently up. Bring that back knee in, and then you're gonna lower down onto your elbows. If that's too much, you just bend the elbows. Otherwise, coming down to the elbows, there should be no pain in the knee, none. And you should be able to keep your knee towards the floor. And just rest here for a moment. We're stretching the quad, just for a moment. And then use your abs, arm strength, lift yourself back up, plant the hands, right foot on the floor, left foot comes up and back. It doesn't have to, you can just come straight down. Right leg up, knee to the chest, pull it in. Come into your pigeon on this side. Either flex the foot, relax the foot, point the foot. Let's bring that left hip forward with our left hand. And then let's twist over to the right. Maybe grab that back thigh gently. Keeping that left hip coming forward, switch to the other side. And breathing through this, feeling where do you, searching with your mind-body awareness, where do you feel the stretch? And then walking forward, either staying up or staying up here. Walking onto your elbows or lengthening your arms all the way out in the full expression of the pose. Breathe here, nice deep long breath. Maybe gently rock side to side or stay on one side or the other. See what happens. Walk yourself up. Bend that left knee. Walk it back, either bending the elbows or coming all the way down. Taking a nice breath here. Maybe you push that hip up and take a side stretch. Okay? And then coming back up, plant the hands. Plant the left foot on the floor, maybe lift the right leg up, maybe not. And just take a moment here. And then we're gonna take a little flow. We're gonna come forward for the shoulders and for strengthening and conditioning. Coming into your plank position, holding it. Want your shoulders away from your ears. Spread your fingers wide. Bring the weight into your thumb and forefinger. Pull your belly in. Again, checking with your shoulders away from your ears. Pull the belly in again, no glutes. Lengthen your legs, inward spiral your legs. Hold. Then I want you to push back to down dog, shoulders away from the ears. Let the neck hang. Come back. Let's roll a little bit and then open the chest. And come back. Two more times. Rolling forward. And if this is not okay right now for your body, you're just going to come into onto your knees and then come back. Into down dog. Let's do that one more time in this way. Head up just a little bit so the neck is in its natural alignment, the spine. And then come back. And then this time, if you're feeling up for it, we're gonna come forward and then we're gonna come forward of our shoulders and bend the elbows just slightly for a chaturanga push-up, straighten the arms, and come back. Let's do that three times. Coming forward, and down, and up, and back. And when you bend the elbows, you want to try to make a 90-degree angle. Forward, and up, and back, and forward, and down, and up, and back. And take a breath here, maybe pedal the feet one more time, lengthen that lower back, and then bring your knees to the floor. Shake your hands out. And let's come to a cross-legged position. And then let's take the left leg out, flexing the foot, hand behind the leg. We're gonna ground down through the right sitting bone, lift up and take a side stretch, looking up at the ceiling. And then we're gonna take a torso rotation and fold over, point the left toe onto the left, maybe grabbing behind the leg. And then we're gonna flex the foot and open back up, arm at a diagonal. Belly pulls in, right sitting bone grounded, left foot flexed, And then point the toe round and fold forward. Exhale. One more time. Inhale. And then exhale. Try to relax the right hip flexor, right knee. And then flex the foot. Come back up. Arm up. Let's take that arm. Just bring the back of the hand behind the lower back. Pull that right shoulder down gently, keeping your side bend going. Maybe bring your hand up to your leg or in front of the leg, or grab the toe or grab the foot and just look gently over your right shoulder. Keep the head looking in that back diagonal direction. Breathe, lift up through the left side body. Maybe flex the foot gently a little bit more. And then release all of that and let's just take a gentle twist towards the right and do all that on the right. Flex the foot, hand behind the leg. Let's inhale, lift up, round down through the left sitting bone as you lengthen at that diagonal. Look up at the ceiling, maybe gently move the left shoulder out of the way, left shoulder blade down the back. Point the toe, fold and twist over that right leg. Flex and open, inhaling, exhale, point and fold and round. Inhale, one more time. Exhale, point and round. And then flex the foot. Let's take this side bend. Hand onto the leg, hand in front, or hand on. Two fingers on the toe, big toe, or hand on the foot. Whatever feels good to you. Left hand, back of palm to lower back. Or you can wrap it around if that feels good to you. Left shoulder down, look over the left shoulder. Gently breathing, pull the belly in. Maybe give your body a little love right now. Say, give it some thanks. Be grateful that you're doing this right now. And then come back to center, both legs out. Feet can just be relaxed. And we're gonna fold forward over to the left. And you wanna bring your pelvis forward with you. So if that means your hands need to be behind your back, that's fine, right? So you're going over to the left and then gently coming over to the right. Your back is nice and round. Yet your pelvis is coming forward with you. So I should say your upper back is rounding. Just going side to side gently right now. And side to side. And side to side. And side to side. Coming all the way up to sitting side to side. I am so into side bending for like a year and a half, 2 years now, something like that. Those of you who work with me on a regular basis know that side bending is like my jam. So bring your feet out in front, flex your feet, bend your legs. Lengthen through the spine. Reach up, 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 up. Try to make a very flat back like you're against a wall. And exhale, flat back, reaching forward. Start to lengthen your legs. And then you can point the toes, pull the belly in, round the lower back, shoulders away from the ears, grab onto your legs, hands on the floor, hands on the feet, whatever feels good. Tuck your chin for a moment, see what happens when you do that. Breathe. Take a moment with your body. How does it feel? How does the stretch feel? Where's your mind at? Just bringing awareness, no judgment. Sitting bones, pulling back. Maybe flex and point the toes. Deep breath. And let's roll up. And while we're here, why don't we just do a little ab exercise and chest open. So I'm going to be in profile here. We're gonna point our toes. We're gonna lift up through the spine, shoulders away from the ears, elbows out. And then we're gonna tuck the pelvis round down. And I want us to just lengthen and roll all the way down, vertebrae by vertebrae, to the floor. So now plant the feet on the floor and you're in this flat back position. And you're gonna bring your arms up directly over your shoulders. And I want you to exhale, pull the belly in, and try to bring your rib cage, the back of your rib cage, towards the floor. And keep your spine still and your pelvis still throughout this whole exercise. Bring your legs up at this diagonal, toes touching, you're making a diamond with your legs. And from here, you're gonna just a hair, or as far as you can, bring your legs out of it and in. And this is all with your belly pulling in, your lower back on the floor, your upper back on the floor, and your pelvis not moving, right? Sitting bones are off the floor now. Out and in. And then you're going to hand the arms, opening. I thought this might be nice. And in.
opening. I did this other the other day in my daily method class, and I love that she did this. I thought it was great. With the arms out, pull that belly in, keep it in. That's the hard part, right? And little diamond with the knees. They're not very far out. They're not farther than your hips. So keep that opening small. Just two more. Pull that belly in. Pelvis doesn't move. Can your spine stay perfectly still? And then just keep your arms, let's keep the arms out and just straighten the legs and bend. Little straighten, little bend. For five, four, three, pull the belly in. You can do it. Two, one, just hold the legs there. You can either keep the arms here or bring them overhead just slightly. Hold it. Five, four, three, two, one. Bring those knees into your chest. Maybe circle them. Get the hip flexors a little relaxed. Release. Lower back rocking, massaging. You guys know the drill. Big knee circles. Let's actually set the feet on the floor. I love to do this. And just drop the knees down. Bring the opposite, the right arm overhead, knees are to the left. And then just switch. Drop the knees, flop them down to the right, left arm overhead. So you're stretching the hip flexors, the side body, the obliques. And then from here, let's just rock and roll three times. Woo! Trying to get that spine nice and massaged out. And let's come up to sitting. We do a little breathing exercises, a little moving meditation. So we'll start with circles. So let's start to the left. You're in this easy pose position and you're making a big circle. You're inhaling to the front, exhaling to the back. Close the eyes. And you can just let the knees go, the sitting bones go, and one more in this direction. And then really round, maybe tip the chin, and then other direction. Big, big circle, like you're stewing a big, stirring a big pot of stew. And then inhale, open the chest, where you feel the stretch, and exhale. And switch the cross of your feet, and let's go the opposite direction. Inhaling, exhale. Closing the eyes. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the nose. And then opposite direction. Big, big circle, allowing the body just to move as big as it needs to or wants to, or small. Although we want to be kind of big here. And then coming to the center, let's come onto our into our tabletop position, into all fours. And if your wrists are sensitive, I just come onto my knuckles. I also want you to have toes touching, knees are hip distance, right under your hips. And we're going to do cat and cow a little bit fast with the eyes closed, and we're going to breathe in through our nose and out through our nose. If that's a problem for you, just breathe in and out through your mouth. Close your eyes. Little inhale, little baby cow pose. Exhale, little baby cat pose. Inhale, exhale. We're trying to get the spine lubricated and awaken and energize. And do a little meditation that's moving so your mind can stay focused. If you know where your third eye is, in between your eyebrows, you can try to gently look there. It's just a gentle look up. You can go as fast or slow as you want. I encourage you to take it a little faster than your normal pace. And it's not as deep as a regular cat and cow pose. Shoulders away from the ears the whole time. Just a few more. Keep focusing on that third eye, or just having the eyes closed, focusing on the inhale, exhale breath, and the spinal movement. And inhale, center, just in neutral. And exhale, push back into your child's pose, wide knees, so your belly's in the center. And lengthen your arms out overhead. You can either just have the palms on the floor, elbows off the floor in an active position, pulling the belly in, rounding the lower back, or you can bring your elbows to the floor. You can bring your hands in prayer. And you can bring your, if your hands are in prayer, you can bring them to the base of your skull or even fist to your skull. Take a moment, give your little neck massage, lower skull massage. Take a big inhale here, dancers. Exhale, pull the belly in, tuck and round even more, and roll up.
then come back to sitting. Straight forward. Let's bring the legs out. Just relax the legs in a comfortable position. It doesn't have to be wide. And then the feet are relaxed. And we're going to inhale, arms up. And we're going to inhale through the nose. And then we're going to exhale, fold over to the left through the mouth. Inhale up through the nose. Exhale through the mouth.
Let it all out on that exhale.
Inhale, close the eyes. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. Take this at your own pace. Again, another moving meditation. The body is moving, the mind is focused on the body movement and the breath. Starting on the left, right? Just one more time each side. Come to center, inhale. Squeeze all of your locks, if you know what that is. Tight, shoulders down, and exhale, release everything. Shake the knees out. Cross the legs. And one more moving meditation here. We're gonna have the elbows up, don't let them drop. So at shoulder height, unless that bothers your shoulders, that's fine to bring them down. Let's try to stay energized if we can. Long spine, we're gonna inhale, close the eyes, through the nose to the left. Exhale, twist to the right. Try to relax the hip flexors and the knees if that's possible. If you need a bolster, you lift up so your knees are lower than your hips. That's always an option, that feels great. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale. And you can take this as vigorously or non-vigorously as you'd like. And as fast or slow as you'd like. Again, closing the eyes and looking at the, taking a gaze at that third eye if that feels good to you. Again, it's a good way to focus and stay focused. It's okay if your thoughts wander. You just be aware of that and bring your attention back to the breathing, to the movement, to the third eye, to the sensations in the body. Just a few more. Last one, left and right. And come to center, inhale. Hold the breath even more. And squeeze all your locks. And exhale, release. Just go forward for a moment, let that all go, let that hang. Come up, and then we're gonna, let's come up through downward dog. Let's just take a moment to down dog. Pedaling the feet, taking a breath here. And then walking the hands back to the feet. Bend the knees, let's come to standing. And I wanna take a little, some little warm-ups here. So let's come into a squat position, feet hip distance apart. Bend the knees, lift your toes so you know the weight is in your heels, and you're trying to sit back like you're trying to reach a chair behind you, all right? And then we're gonna bring our arms, where do I want our arms? Let's bring our arms out for now. You can bring your toes back down, and make sure your knees are never going in front of the toes, right? Internally rotate your thighs. Sitting bones are wide, belly pulls in, shoulders are down. Just taking little pulses down, 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 down. So let's try to take some bicep curls here. So let's take it up and down. And really on that squeeze in, squeeze those biceps. Come down as low as you can. And if that's not working for you today, just take a little gentle bend. Let's take it here for 4, 3, 2, and 1, and a little bit faster. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and one more round like that. 1, 2, belly pulls in, you're folding forward, yet sitting back in the heels, and 8 fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then just hold it down, bring your arms behind your back. I thought this would be great to open the chest a little and get some triceps in there, some tricep condition. So straighten the arms, palms are facing each other. Try to bring them close together. And just bend and reach the arms. It's the tiniest bend so that you can reach farther and get into those triceps, right? Back, two, three, four, stretch, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. We're gonna come up with the arms in this V shape and come down. This is it for these squats. Up, but this would also be good for the shoulders. If you go to Burning Man, this always reminds me of like the Burning Man symbol. Up, just two more. Up, down, make sure you're squatting back and down in the heels and hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna come into a wide turned out second position. We're gonna bring the arms here. You can make fists or have the hands open. We're gonna come up, bring the elbows in, down, and then bring the elbows towards the behind your waist and up, in, and down. Coming up and down in these second position wide turned out squats. Breathing, we're almost done. Down, up, down, up. Let's see, two more sets. And last one. Up, hold it here for 5, 4, pull your belly in, sit upright. 3, 2, 1. Woo, shake it out. And last thing, we're gonna bring the feet into this, not very wide, unless you would like to, first position. And we're gonna bend the knees. And if you need to, you're just gonna stay right here. You're gonna bend and reach, bend and reach. Otherwise, I want you to come all the way down, heels off the floor, hands on the floor, fingertips, and you're gonna either keep the feet in releve or bring them down to the floor, but you're gonna straighten the legs, fold forward, head towards your chest, and come back up. We're gonna do 8 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, just 4 more, guys. And last one. And flip forward, bring your feet to parallel, bend the knees, tuck the pelvis, bring the pelvis to the floor, tailbone to the floor, roll it up in the vertebrae. Feel that. Shake it out for a minute. Just take a little side stretch. Little side stretch, just whatever feels good. Moving the arms in different ways. Maybe just staying up here. Whew. Maybe getting the hips a little Maya action going on. Just a little, right? And let the hands go. And then I want you to just play around with the hands for a moment. So letting the hands be relaxed and as if they're the most graceful, delicate thing. I want you to move the body, move the feet, but really focusing on the hands and how fragile and delicate they can be through space. Just playing around with them, and they're super graceful, super soft, right? Just a gentleness through the hands, just floating around. And then I want you to start feeling the joints and making the hands a little more active as they move. So moving the finger joints, the wrist joints, maybe the elbow joints, and just making everything a little more active as you work those hands and the body a little bit. And then take this kind of puttaka mudra, so all the fingers are straight, everything's tight, and just work the hands through space while you're moving with the hands in this position. Just a little warm-up, different kind of warm-up that my teacher did recently that I really loved. Right? And then just shake it out and just take a little torso rotation. We are at the end here, just about. Just want to do a few more things. So just torso twist, just letting everything go, maybe hitting the body, right? Whew. Hopefully it feels good, getting the synovial fluid going in the vertebrae, getting that vertebrae going. And then I want you to just jump and shake for a minute, right? Be a little silly, just shake it out, shake your feet, shake your butt, shake your head, shake your chest, shake your belly. Shake your hands, shake your arms, just shake. Maybe jump up and down. Jump and shake it out. Woo! can't believe I'm being so silly in front of you, but this feels so good. Shaking a few times a week or every day, it just feels good. Keep shaking, guys. Try to keep shaking if you can. Balancing, if that's too much on your joints, just keep the feet grounded. Just kicking one leg or the other. Moving around. Shake everything again. Shake your knees. Shake your feet. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Shake it, shake it, shake it. And then let's finish up on the floor. Let's come down onto our bellies. So coming down onto your knees. Just walk yourself forward. Come onto your belly. And let's take King Dancer or Dancer's Pose on the floor. So let's start with the left. Bring the left foot towards your butt. Grab the ankle. Right arm is overhead. Head towards the floor. Pull your belly in away from the floor. Tuck the pelvis forward and gently pull the heel towards your butt or lift the knee off the floor and just hold. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Maybe you lift the chest up a little more. Maybe you pull the leg away. That's all up to you. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Try to bring the breath back to normal and release that foot. Grab the right ankle. Try not to grab the foot. Try to grab the ankle. Tuck the pelvis, belly pulls in. Tuck the pelvis towards the ground. Keep tucking it, and keep gently pulling the knee away. Push the ankle into your hand. Maybe lift up. Maybe if you want more chest opening, you're gonna bring both hands. And then release, and we'll just end with a child's pose. Wide knee, child's pose, belly in between, arms out, again, taking whatever position. Anjali Mudra, prayer mudra, hands into the floor, elbows off the floor, elbows on the floor, maybe this time, especially if we're relaxing, arms at your side. And just breathe, 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 and breathe, and allow yourself a moment. Take a moment to appreciate your body, and give your own self some love. Congratulate yourself for carving out some time to do this. Let's all take a deep breath and inhalation together. And then exhale, just release. Pull the belly in, exhaling, keeping that exhale and round up to sitting. And I want to thank you guys for working with me. Yay!
Bye. See you next time, hopefully.